welcome you to the call today. I'm very, very excited, thrilled to be a part of this. I'm also joined today with my very, very dear friend, Frances Flynn Thorson. Today, what we're going to do is we want to share some very, very important information about government homes. And there's so much misinformation out there right now about government homes. And I think it's really, really important that, you know, what we want to do is we want to create the HUD initiative that brings the correct information to the real estate industry. And just like the title of the slide says, one of the things that, and the slides will be coming up in just a moment, there's so many opportunities right now for people to be making money in the HUD home market. There's opportunities to also help with this excess inventory of foreclosed properties. And one of the things that I get asked all the time is, what is a HUD home? And we're going to be going through all of that today. We're going to be talking about, you know, what's happening within the marketplace and what you can do to dominate in that marketplace. And I'm just very, very excited to be able to be a part of this initiative with Fran. Fran, we're going to go ahead and put up our slides and give everybody an opportunity to be able to just see some of the notes that we have today. Fran, anything that you want to say for just an opening hello, just to say hi to all your friends out there?
Yeah, hello, everybody. I am happy to be here. Nice to be in new digs here right now on Instant Teleseminar. It's a real neat platform. We have lots of new information. There's lots of new information about HUD homes that's even new this week that's happening. So it's very, very timely. And I am extremely honored and pleased and happy and having a whole lot of fun working with Denise Lonis on our first joint venture. So I'm enjoying this.
Well, thanks, Fran. So one of the things that I want everyone to know, because I get this, you know, I get asked this all the time, is what is a HUD home? What does that mean? And a lot of people don't really even understand, you know, what are HUD homes? What does that look like? And today, Fran and I are going to share some really valuable information with you, really give you some great ideas about, you know, what's going on in the HUD home market. And for those that don't know, HUD homes comprise one of the largest inventories of foreclosed properties in the whole United States. These are properties that are owned by the United States Department of Housing and Urban Development, HUD. And a HUD home is basically a property that has been lost by a previous owner in a foreclosure. And one of the things that happens with that is that property gets given back to the lender with a deed in lieu of foreclosure. That property owner then faces financial difficulties, and we've seen all so much of that. And in the case of a HUD home, the property owner, that's a person who had obtained the FHA mortgage to purchase or refinance the property, what happens is that property goes back to HUD. HUD has to do something with these properties. That's very important. So in the next 60 to 75 minutes, what we're going to do is we're going to share with you everything that we've learned about the HUD home market. And in many ways, HUD homes also will give anyone listening on this line an opportunity to heal the real estate market. And there's just such an excess of this foreclosed inventory out there. And one of the things that is really important to know is that, you know, you can be a part of it. Because as you're going to learn later, this, you know, the HUD Homes initiative is an initiative to reduce this inventory. Also, everybody wins with HUD Homes. The buyers win. Asset managers win. Housing market wins. And agents win. HUD Homes are a part of the market that if you don't already know about it, you have got to learn it. You cannot ignore this any longer. And today's call is going to be a really great step just to give you as much information as we possibly can. And some of you that are listening today on the call just want to learn, what's a HUD home? What do I need to know? Maybe I want to learn, you know, a little bit. And we're going to do a great job, hopefully, of providing you a good overview. Others are going to want to really know how to dominate in their marketplace, really become a HUD specialist and expert. And later on in the call, we will share with you how you can do just that. So first of all, I want to take a moment. I want to tell you a little bit about Fran. And when I'm done, she'll tell you a little bit about me. But this is an incredible woman. Fran is, she has impressed me. She absolutely is the HUD home specialist. First of all, she literally wrote the book on HUD homes. In fact, she has written two books on HUD homes. She has a passion not only for HUD homes, but she also has a passion to really make a difference and to see that this foreclosed inventory, that something's done about it. And she has spent a lot of time not just involved in learning about HUD homes, but she spent 20 years in the trenches selling HUD homes. So she knows her stuff. you know, one of the things that you have to keep in mind about, you know, the HUD Home Initiative, as we're gonna call that, is that the reason that more HUD homes are not sold is, frankly, because agents don't really know about them, and they don't know about all the new rules and regulations. You know, Fran was an expert in HUD homes so long ago, you know, before you could even search for them online. And, Fran, I hope that doesn't make you sound too mature, but that's really the fact, you know. And I know, Fran, that you and I have talked about the fact that back in your day, you'd pick up a copy of the newspaper every Wednesday. You'd go and check and see what the HUD homes were that had come on and were available that week. You'd then look if something, you know, was interesting to you. You would then have to drive 10 miles just to pick up a key to show that property. And, you know, that was back in the day before the key boxes. And I was also around way back in the day before key boxes. And it just made that whole process that much more difficult. So I think you can agree that Fran's many years of experience is going to really come in handy today. And I'm thrilled and excited. And most of all, Fran, I'm honored to be a part of the HUD Initiative with you. And I want you to take a moment to share with the listeners, what is the HUD Initiative and why should they care about it? And how can this, you know, help them, and how does it affect them?
Yeah, I would be happy to. I'm very, very pleased to. And I would like to point out to everybody who's here, who's on the webcast, that that I did three other video tutorials this week with a lot of background information. So there's a lot of, like, what is a HUD home, and about information that's right on the page you're looking at. If you're watching the webcast, on the top left, there's another whole video tutorial about the Good Neighbor Next Door program that we're going to talk about here, and another one about working and looking for the listing. So we have three tutorials up. If you haven't seen that, look at that. And bear in mind that, you know, HUD homes are homes that people have lost. And they lost it because they had personal circumstances that made it hard to keep up with the mortgage, and they came into the market after default. And, those are sad circumstances, and in many places in the country, certainly here in Arizona, lots and lots of people are suffering and facing foreclosure and losing their homes. So one of the things that we're doing as part of our initiative, and as far as I know, we're the first real estate educational class to do this, because we're working to help teach agents how to sell these foreclosed properties. We are actually going to be giving back 20% of everything we make on the launch here to a group of people. And what you see on the screen right now is a picture of a young gentleman. His name is Gabe Zimmerman, and we're going to be giving 20% of the money to a group here in Pima County in Arizona, who is working with people facing foreclosure and distressed homeowners. Gabe Zimmerman died recently. He was shot, and you probably saw all about it. He was working with Gabby Giffords, our representative in Congress. And Gabe was a very, very hard worker. He was a social worker. He headed her marketing campaign. But he worked very, very hard in the foreclosure field. I used to see him at foreclosure events, at planning events, places where I used to speak, and Gabby used to speak. And I knew him quite well. So he died, working with Gabby. And we're going to make a gift, and a continuing gift, in Gabe's name, here in Pima County. So the 20% of the money that comes in is going to go back into the field to help people who are facing foreclosure, distressed homeowners, and it's just our way of giving back. So I'm very, very happy to be able to share that.
Wonderful.
And let me introduce Denise then, because Denise Lomas is a very extraordinary lady. Denise has been in the business also for more than 20 years. And she's worked as an agent, she's worked as a broker, she's also a real estate analyst, a columnist, a consultant, and a coach. And this lady gets it. She gets it about all aspects of real estate and Web 2.0. She has a company called the Lomas Group. They do some amazing marketing materials. And like me, she's educating agents on opportunities to do the right thing and make money doing the right thing. I'm really, really tickled, you know, to meet somebody who shares a passion for HUD homes. It's not every day I meet somebody with a passion for HUD homes, and not only for HUD homes, but a passion that I have for healing the real estate market. We both know that HUD homes can make a positive difference not only in the lives of buyers, but also for those agents smart enough to tap into this amazing opportunity.
Wow. Thank you, Fran. Those are nice words. I appreciate that. You know, one of the things that I have been very, very passionate and outspoken about is the feeling that I have about what's happened within our industry, with the economy, with people that, you know, clients I've had that are good, hardworking real estate agents out there that, you know, really no fault of their own, they have lost their homes to a foreclosure. You know, if you're not making any income and people aren't buying and selling real estate, it really has hit our industry very hard. So I am very passionate about that. Now, the reason that we're here today and why everyone is at this webcast is because there have been so many changes. There have been a lot of changes recently to the HUD program. In fact, there's 5 major changes, and we're going to talk about those a little bit later on. But one of the things that happened recently, Fran, for you, and I'm thrilled about it, is that you put together a new certification program for government home sales professionals. It's called the GHSP, which stands for the Government Homes Sales Professional. The training for the GHSP certification really goes in depth into everything a person needs to know about HUD homes. You know, one of the things that people don't really understand, and it's this myth about HUD homes, is they think that HUD homes are not homes that their clients can purchase. And in fact, they are. Owner-occupants is one of the biggest categories of who's out there buying a HUD home. So that's one of the great myths is, well, what does this have to do with me? Isn't HUD home some government program for people that don't have money? I mean, that's what I hear time and time again. That is not true. HUD homes, you know, fall into a number of categories. You know, anyone can buy a HUD home. It could be an owner-occupant. It could be under the Good Neighbor Next Door program. It could be investors. Even though they can't bid until day 31, they still can be a part of it. Government agencies are buying HUD homes. Nonprofits are buying HUD homes. So that is the myth. So today what we're going to talk about and what we are going to help you learn is, you know, first and foremost, what's the number one thing you should be focusing on to get big results when you start making a pitch for HUD homes? So what is this? Well, most agents don't know what this is. We're going to talk about that. We're also going to go over 5 easy, simple steps that you have got to take if you're going to dominate the HUD home arena in your marketplace. You just have to do them. Also, how do you triple your buyer leads by working with HUD homes? Because there's a huge opportunity out there to get leads that come in because people are interested in HUD homes, and then maybe there isn't one of the HUD homes there that they like, but now you've got that client. The other thing we're going to look at is what are the magic words you've got to use even if you're working with the most skeptical asset manager. We're going to talk a lot more about that in a little bit. And also, what's the best way to present HUD homes to buyers and investors? You want to be able to present this so that that now is an option for them, because for a lot of people, it's not. Now, this program is definitely for you if you are sick and tired of working with short sales that never close. Short sales are not closing for you. It's a huge problem. Let's say that you want to leverage your expertise with distressed properties. If you want to chart new territory with government-owned homes and you just don't know how to do this, this program is for you. Also, if you want to tap into a market where very, very few agents have expertise, I have to tell you, this is one of the most powerful lead generation systems I've ever seen, because the reality is that there is a lot of information that you've got to learn about to be a HUD homes expert. Many agents, many people involved in the industry are not interested in doing that. Also, for brokers, for owners, for managers of real estate companies, if you want to dominate in your marketplace, what a powerful niche market. And I have to say, because I hear this from managers and owners and brokers all the time, they'll say things like this: well, you know, someone else in our marketplace has most of those listings. Well, of course they do, because nobody's challenging that. Nobody is showing the asset managers, those are the people that have the listing inventory and they give it out, nobody's showing them a better way. You know, it's just like any other real estate transaction. You've got to articulate your value. And you're not going to be able to do that if you don't know what that asset manager is looking for, because the asset manager's job is to sell that property. And, in fact, if they don't sell that property in 180 days, it's going to create a huge problem, because that property will then be sold to the municipality for a dollar. So talk about a high motivation level. So if you want to make money, you want to make money quickly, maybe you want to help some of the most important individuals in the community, first responders and teachers. We'll talk more about that in a bit. If you want to help these people, this is an incredible program to know about. So we're going to share some information today. It's going to inspire you. It's going to make a change in your business. And don't be overwhelmed. First of all, I know that right now, for a lot of people that are on this call, they may be thinking, look, I don't even know that much about HUD homes, you know. I don't know if I want to learn that much about HUD homes. Also, many agents don't know that there is a really great opportunity here of regular ongoing leads. So it's very, very important. And, you know, don't be afraid of the process. You know, don't be afraid of what you don't know. Don't be afraid of the forms. That's another big thing is, you know, when you look at how many times in the last 10 years the forms have changed, the contract of purchase and sale has changed, you know, that old HUD, you know, contract of purchase and sale and some of the forms have stayed the same for many, many years. So it's not as difficult as it sounds, but there are some process changes. There are some rules and regulations that have changed. You have to know about that. So if you're ready for positive change, you got to put all those fears aside and you got to be open to learning something new. So we want to talk about a fundamental change in the industry, one that's going to not only enhance your business, but it's going to help others, because if these HUD homes can get sold, that reduces inventory and that's good for everybody. You know, it's one of these things that agents just need to be more open to learning, because if you're not open to it, somebody else is going to take advantage of this, because this is it. This is a huge opportunity. I have been in the industry for decades, and I have to tell you that had this been available when I was actively selling, I would have been so excited to be a part of this, because this really gives you an opportunity to showcase your talent. So one of the things I want to talk about first is, you know, how many homes are there right now on the market? You know, what kind of inventory is out there? You know, is there 10 homes in the marketplace, 100, 1,000? How much inventory actually is there? So one of the things that I want you to think about is that this inventory is really, if we look at, let's say, a picture of a pie, for example, currently right now there is $8 billion in HUD home inventory. That is an $8 billion pie. It's huge, and that conservatively translates into over $400 million in commission. And if you look at the picture of the pie, you'll see that there are different categories of people that buy HUD homes. And as I said earlier, owner-occupants make up the biggest piece of that pie. It's incredible. Yes, there's investors. Yes, you've got first responders. You've got municipalities, and you've got nonprofits. But owner-occupants is a very big piece of that pie. If I was an agent today, as I said earlier, I would be drooling. So what exactly does this mean for you? How can you get involved in this part of the market? How can you get involved in this niche? What I want to do, Fran, is I want you to kind of take us through the process and tell us what's going on right now with HUD homes today.
Absolutely. That's my pleasure. And HUD sales are, you know, HUD home sales is a way that most people get involved. And again, I've been doing that, or I was doing that for many, many years. And in the old days, and when I say the old days, I'm talking about prior to October of 2010. Because in October of 2010, HUD enacted the most wide-ranging and exhaustive kind of redesign of their REO program that they ever did before. You know, and I haven't seen anything like this since the 90s. And it's just very, very exciting. There are new players in the game. We've got a lot of people on our call today who are called asset managers. These are contractors who are working for HUD as part of this new management bureaucracy. They used to have what was called the M&M program, the marketing and maintenance managers. And they divided the responsibilities at HUD, the contractor responsibilities, in three major departments. And the ones that real estate agents really need to know the most about are the asset managers and the field service managers. And the asset managers actually right now have total discretion and authority to make local listing broker assignments. In the old days, when there was a broad listing broker, often it was somebody who handled an entire state. It was a long-term contract, and once the contract was awarded, you know, nobody else really had a chance to do anything. But right now, there are multiple listing brokers in most parts of the country, in most market areas. And a lot of this is happening as a test right now, because everybody's being watched very, very carefully. Asset managers are being graded on their performance. As Denise said, they had They have 180 days to get a property sold before it goes on the market for a dollar for a municipality. And the more, you know, the sooner they can sell them, the more money they can sell them for, the better they're going to look at HUD, and the better the chance they have of keeping their jobs and moving forward. And they are working with local listing brokers who also are being graded. You know, these are, you know, when you're a listing agent, you've got to do the job. And so where before there were just a few people doing listings and most people were doing sales, right now, you know, we've got a really, really good opportunity to be doing sales also, and pitching for listings. And we're going to be talking about that because there are phenomenal, phenomenal opportunities. There are new rules in the game right now. Some of the rules are the same, you know, the advertising guidelines are the same. But we have new bid periods. Again, you know, owner occupants have a longer priority period. They have a 30-day owner occupant priority period now. That's brand new, and that's for FHA insured properties. So if it's an FHA insured property or an FHA insured with repair escrow, so there are some repairs that need to be done, those owner occupants have priority for 30 days. But if a new property comes on the market that is not insurable and it's an uninsured property, it only has owner occupant priority for 5 days, and on day 6 an investor can come in and make an offer. A lot of people don't realize this. A lot of people are saying, oh, I don't want to work with HUD Opens anymore because investors are cut out. Not true. Not true. It's a better time than ever for owner-occupants, for investors, for real estate agents. In all my years in this business, I have never seen anything so exciting than what's happening in the HUD homes market today. Again, we've got a bunch of asset managers on this call with us here today. They're very, very excited about our initiative. They're very, very excited about our training. They're very, very excited about getting more people involved in this process. There's a brand new website, HUDHomestore.com. Again, I did 3 trainings on this, 3 video trainings, and you want to take a look at that. Because now real estate agents and brokers have to sign in at HUDHomestore.com if you submit a bid. You know, there's one website for the entire country, and that's at HUDHomestore.com. So not only does a broker have to get an NAID number and be approved and registered with HUD, but that broker must also register at HUDHomestore.com, and any real estate agents who are allowed in that brokerage to place bids also have to register at HUDHomestore.com. Very, very important, and very, very important to know who does what. Now, HUDHomestore.com is managed by a company called Yardi, and that's a separate contractor. So if you have a problem getting registered, you know, you need to be in touch with either your asset manager or your HUD home ownership center, and you know, in the appropriate region, you know, to take care of those details. But HUD listings are going to be wonderful, wonderful prizes for people. And you don't have to be a real big broker. They're working with a lot of people, they're entertaining offers, and it's very, very exciting. Very, very exciting.
And Fran, one of the other things that has changed that I think is wonderful, at HUDHomestore.com, now the listings are entered on a daily basis instead of once a week, because back in the good old days, you know, that you'd race to, you know, let me go look at those listings on that weekly basis. Now that has changed. So I want to talk now about some things that we can do to help the listeners understand how to dominate this market. You know, what does that look like? How can we take advantage of the market? So there's 5 critical steps an agent needs. They have to understand these steps. If they don't understand it, this is going to definitely be, you know, a detriment to them. You have to win. You know, as Fran said, there are asset managers on the line. The asset managers are looking for agents that are great negotiators. And I want to I really want to go back to a comment that was made to me, you know, a couple of days ago when I was talking to one of my clients about HUD Homes. One of the comments that she said to me, and she said, oh, this is great, this could be the answer. And I said to her, well, this isn't a magic pill that you're going to take, because you still have to go back to the basics of being able to create strong relationships with these asset managers. You have to be an effective listing agent if you are going to win the respect of that asset manager. And imagine that you do get a listing or a number of listings. The bottom line is you have to be able to sell these properties. So it isn't just, I'm going to get listings and make a lot of money. You do have to work for those. Very important. So 5 steps, very important. The first step is that you better know the HUD market. You have to know everything there is to know about this market. Now, if you were to try to find this out on your own, this would take you months to learn. One of the nice things is that, you know, Fran has done a really great job of doing this research, and I have worked with HUD Homes during my career. You've got to, it's very important that you have these steps, and you've got the knowledge, and you've got the training. So, Fran, why don't you share with our listeners exactly what they need to know? When I say step one, know the HUD market, what does that mean to our listeners?
Well, that means they need to know what the HUD, what's happening with the HUD homes in that market. Again, everything is at, almost everything is at HUDHomestore.com, and let me qualify that. All of the listings in the whole country are appearing there. All of the property detail information, all of the contracts attached to it are all very, very easy, and you can reach that at a glance. All of the contact information. One of the things you need to do is to know about HUD Homes, because the listing agents are featured very, very prominently on HUD Home Store as a major contact. Every single property on HUD Home Store has a printable flyer that has a printing that has a listing agent's name. So if you're a listing agent for a HUD home, that is very cool, because buyers will be going there. They'll be printing off flyers. You'll have a lot of people printing flyers, looking at that. And I have people already telling me from all over the country, agents who are telling me they're losing buyers to the listing agent. So you need to have a handle on the HUD homes in your market so you don't lose it if you're not a listing agent. And then you need to know what you need to do to be a listing agent if you want to, if that's where you want to go with it. The other thing is that in the past, there used to be other information available relative to bid statistics and accepted bids, and that was a little bit more transparent. That's not available anymore. So you've got to do a little bit more research. You've got to work on those sales statistics with your multi-list in a way that you didn't before. And unless and until that information becomes available, you know, we've got to come up with those numbers in a different way.
Excellent. Well, the second step, the second part of the process you have to understand is just that. Know what the HUD process is. So what that means is that, okay, what are the steps that I take? What does this look like? You know, what specifically should I be doing? What shouldn't I be doing? Fran, the process has changed a little bit. Agents, you know, again, have to know what those changes are. But tell us a little bit about the HUD process.
Yeah, the HUD process itself hasn't changed a whole lot. I mean, the HUD process is you show a house to a buyer, and if they're interested, they have to be fully approved. You have to be working with a pre-qualification letter that you're going to have to submit in case your bid is accepted. They have to be working with real current information. So if you're working with a buyer, they have to have a pre-qualification letter from a lender that says that their credit's been looked at, and that letter can't be more than 30 days old. If they want to write an offer on a property, you've got to do it in written form. You have to have it signed. You have to have it signed in blue ink, and you have to collect earnest money deposit in certified funds, and you have to have that in your hands before you place the bid. If, you know, the bid goes online, but you have to have the contract signed first, you have to have the earnest monies in your hand, because if your bid is accepted, and then you have to send the paperwork to the asset manager, it has to be there in 2 business days after the acceptance. That paperwork has to be signed with a date that precedes the submission online, and that earnest money instrument, whether that's a certified check or a money order, the date that was drawn has to be before the bid was put, or the day of the day the bid was put online. A lot of agents have been a little bit lackadaisical about this, and maybe they'll submit a bid and then do the paperwork later or collect the monies. You can't do that, because you're putting you're putting the deal at risk if you do that. So you've really gotta dot your I's and cross your T's and do it right. They're looking at this very carefully. I was on a call with HUD people just a couple days ago. They're not going to be putting up with that kind of an attitude anymore. So you've got to do this. There is a zero tolerance policy in many areas, and if you break one of those rules, your bid can be kicked out. One of the big differences that's happening right now is that asset managers are working very aggressively in most parts of the country with offers that were placed that didn't make it when deals are falling through. So, you know, that's unfortunately another problem, you know, that people are working with buyers who may not be qualified, and deals are falling through for various reasons, and asset managers are keeping their options open, and they're looking at backup offers. So in many cases before, they didn't even look at, they've never looked at them, and you either checked the backup box or not, and it didn't matter. But right now, there are notices on HUDHomestore.com and disclaimers that say, you know, property is subject to removal at the asset manager's discretion, and they're, you know, they may be considering backup offers. They want to get these sold. That's the bottom line. If a deal falls through and there were some other people that placed offers, they may be on the phone, they may be calling people, they may be putting some deals together on bids that were rejected. And this is a brand new phenomenon. We've never seen this happen. So be aware of that. You know, prepare your buyers for that and move ahead. The other thing about the process is you have to be really, really diligent about owner-occupant being bona fide owner-occupant. There's been a lot of fraud. There has been a lot of fraud involving investors who said they were owner-occupants in massive numbers. A lot of those people have not been taken to task, but they're going to be working very, very closely with the Inspector General's office. They're going to be publishing Inspector General hotlines. They want to find out when people are breaking this rule, and they're going to start coming down on it. And there's a possible fine of $250,000, imprisonment of 2 years. They haven't been doing this. I've been screaming about this for years, and I just wanted to get up and say hallelujah, because they're going to start doing that. So be aware of that. HUD has estimates that about 29% of all of their HUD home sales involved fraud with investors who are calling themselves owner-occupants. Those days are coming to an end. You know, you need to know that. You know, if that's something that's common and customary in your area, you know, think twice, you know, and just be ready for that.
And that's actually, Fran, a really good point. A lot of people don't realize that back in 2004, for example, some of the programs under HUD were actually suspended because of a fairly large scandal and basically widespread abuse. So, you know, at least now there is definitely some more firm regulations and, you know, policing of that, so to speak. Let's move on to our next step, Fran, and that is the branding do's and don'ts. Okay, this is really, really an important point. If you are going to sell HUD homes, you have to understand this. Fran, let's talk about it.
Yeah, and the branding do's and don'ts, actually, for me, I learned the hard way that HUD homes and marketing HUD homes just exploded my business years and years ago. And I marketed them very, very aggressively. But what happened to me was that I branded them so much that people thought it was all I did. And I didn't have something in place at the time, and I was selling HUD homes and working a whole lot with them, but I didn't really have a head in those days for branding myself and my business. And, you know, HUD homes is a niche. It's a part of your business. And you can find out that people are going to start coming from all directions once you start talking about them. And I know that people are going to come and they're going to say, oh my God, I can't believe this, because I couldn't believe it. So, you know, brand yourself appropriately and make sure you have a strong brand. I think that's one of the real neat things that Denise does in her business is work with real good, strong brands. I mean, it was really sad for me to see properties going on the market and people putting listings on the market that I had sold them when I had good relationships. And when I would bump into people, they would say, you know, I thought you just sold HUD homes and VA homes. I didn't know you did regular real estate, because I was so connected with the HUD homes brand. So, you know, take a look at your branding and just, you know, consider that as part, you know, when you're moving forward.
And one of the things, you know, when I talk about branding, it's really important that agents understand that this is a part of your business. And what happens when you do start branding yourself as somebody that has this as an area of specialty is people will contact you and they're going to be interested in HUD homes. But for whatever reason, they don't buy a HUD home, but they're still going to buy a home. And this is one of the beauties of working with HUD homes, is there's such an opportunity for, you know, other business, which is great. The next step we're going to talk about is the Good Neighbor Next Door program. And, Fran, I'm going to get your thoughts on this in just a minute, but I just want to share with our listeners, you know, most agents that I speak with either do not have a clue what this program is, or they don't believe this program exists in their area, or they've heard from other agents that there's just so many problems with this program. And in fact, you know, a lot of those things are simply myths. And people say, well, what is the Good Neighbor Next Door program? And then when you say to them that this program has been designed for first responders and teachers to be eligible for a special program that gives them literally a 50% discount off the list price of a HUD home, the people that I talk to say, wait a minute, how is that fair? I'm not a teacher. I have another job, and, you know, my job is important. And the reason that the program was designed in the first place was because it was designed to help reduce crime, to raise student test scores, to promote better relationships, you know, between inner city residents. And, you know, this is for police officers and teachers and EMTs and first responders, firefighters. So that's why the program was designed. But, Fran, I want you to kind of just get rid of those myths about it and just tell us the real, you know, truth of the Good Neighbor program.
Yeah, that's what it is. It is a program that gives eligible participants 50% off. Again, I did a tutorial on this. A video tutorial is on the page. It's a tutorial number 2. There are special properties, so not all properties apply. But when you do see one, if you see Good Neighbor Next Door properties in your area, it's an amazing opportunity to reach out to the community in law enforcement, to reach out to teachers. Because, you know, does every teacher need a house or want a house at 50% off? No, of course not. But, you know, everybody wants to know about it. You know, everybody wants to be there because everybody knows somebody who qualifies when those properties come on the market. Now, I'm going to tell you a quick secret that most people don't know about this, and that is that real estate agents now participate in the Good Neighbor Next Door program. In the old days, before October of 2010, the Good Neighbor Next Door people and those who were eligible submitted their own bid, so real estate agents didn't get paid for it. Now you do. And now there's competition involved. So even though HUD Home Store says lottery next to these, it's not a lottery. It used to be a lottery, and the way it used to work was that the cops and the firefighters and everybody, they would put their bids in, and they would all be put in as a full-price offer, and then HUD would pick a name out of a hat or however they did it, and it was a lottery. And there was no competition. And interestingly enough, these properties are marked with the word lottery, but the word lottery doesn't really apply because if you are working with a cop and he wants that property, let's say the property is listed at 100, and most people think, oh, well, it's a lottery, so you put in a full price offer and then you get it for 50. So most people are going to put in a full price offer, but you put in an offer of 110, and you're going to have a higher net proceeds number on your bid for HUD, and then he gets it. And then the price is set at 55 because it's set at 55%. So even though it says lottery, it's not really a lottery, and most people don't know that, but you know that now.
Well, and the bottom line, too, is that, you know, HUD is all about net proceeds. And one of the things that you talk about a lot, and I just love it, some examples that are in the certification program that we're going to talk about in just a few minutes, you actually show really in-depth examples of, okay, so if you are representing a buyer, what are some things that you can do to make your offer look more attractive? And it's really, you know, that's what it's about. Remember, the asset managers, you know, their job is to sell those properties and to, you know, they're there to have HUD's best interest in mind. Of course, they're going to accept an offer that is going to bring a higher net proceeds to HUD. So you have to know the little tricks and the secrets on how to get those offers accepted. Okay, step 5, a bridge to special markets. Okay, this is very cool, Fran. I love this part. Talk about the special markets and, you know, ways that you can take advantage of these.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there are parts of this market that you just don't, I mean, of course, the Good Neighbor Next Door program, it works for the demographic. But there are other parts of government homes markets that become available through HUD Homes purchases. Let me give you an example. Nonprofits are buying HUD homes right now. They don't need real estate agents anymore to buy them because they can get their own NAID number, but they have a lot of grant monies, and municipalities have a lot of grant monies. And so they can place their own bids, and they don't need real estate agents to do that, but they're using real estate agents to sell those properties. So become aware of what your nonprofits are doing. There's a very, very large, there are billions and billions of dollars that were spent in stimulus funds. And here in Arizona, we literally have hundreds of millions of dollars in stimulus monies that are being spent by the nonprofits and government agencies who are buying foreclosed properties, rehabbing them, greening them, and then putting them back on the market, and they're using realtors. And because there's such a disconnect in so many cases between the housing community and real estate, most of the realtors in town don't know about these projects. Know about that. Go take a housing counselor to lunch. Take a housing counselor to lunch and talk about the national stabilization project where they're working on neighborhoods. They're buying HUD properties. They may not need you to buy the HUD property, but when they fix it up, they need you to sell it. And so HUD homes can be a wonderful bridge to doing that.
Well, the other thing that is so I hear a lot is, you know, I don't know if I want to sell HUD homes because I really don't want to work with buyers. And you know what? I really don't think that I'm ever going to get the business of the asset manager. Okay, that's fine. What about getting out there and making great relationships with the municipalities and the nonprofits? They need you to sell, any real estate that they are going to sell. They don't want to be a listing agent. So never underestimate the different kinds of special markets that are out there because they're there. You just have to have a plan. You need to know what you're going after. You need to be strategic about it. We're going to talk about marketing campaigns in just a moment. But, Fran, there's also a way that you can triple your buyer leads. This is another really cool thing that you teach in the class, which I just love. So let's talk about that.
Yeah, well, and again, people may not want to be working with a whole lot of buyers, but that doesn't mean that you can't capitalize on the buyer market, too, because one of the things that's going to happen when you start to market HUD homes is you're going to get a lot of leads. And I should have known a lot more about this, you know, years ago, because before I knew what I didn't know, and I had a website even 10 years ago, I was generating 3 to 6 leads every single day. And I was picking the ones that I liked and working with the people I liked and the other stuff fell through the cracks. I mean, take a look at what people are paying right now for buyer leads. They're paying $350 to some companies for 10 to 12 leads in a month, and then another $250 for every 10 after that. I mean, you don't have, it's a dollar business model. I'm not going to say that it's not good, but if you can get 3 to 5 a day, I mean, you get this by working just working a little smart and having a blog and shaking some hands. I mean, it's real estate 101. I think God help me, you know, the real estate gods and social media gods in Chicago are probably going to strike me down dead. But you can get more leads, you know, printing off a flyer in a multi-list the day a property comes on the market and walking up and down the street and meeting people than a lot of people I know, you know, with the hours they're spending on Twitter and God knows where.
You know, we're going to talk about, and Fran, I want to talk about this because there is a lot of misconceptions around HUD homes and what is the best way to market them. So I want to talk now a little bit about marketing and outreach plans. And I want to, you know, I really want to tie into what Fran is saying. First of all, you have to understand that if you are going to work with HUD homes, you have to have an outreach plan. You have to have a marketing plan. You've got to put that together. So first of all, an outreach plan is your marketing plan. You're going to have the most success when you work with HUD homes if you create what I'm going to call the balanced outreach plan or that balanced marketing plan. And, of course, you have to be prepared to handle the leads that come in, and they will. When I was an active broker and managed a very large real estate office, one of my agents did not like working with buyers, but this agent was brilliant at marketing. And what she did is she did all the marketing to get HUD buyers all excited to work with her, and then she basically just said, you know what, I'm booked for the next 2 weeks, but I have an agent over here that can help you. Many of those people ended up buying HUD homes. Many of those people ended up not buying HUD homes, but the point was this agent, who really had no desire to even work within the HUD home market, what she was doing was leveraging her ability to market. That's what she did. She was a fantastic marketer, and she did some, you know, very traditional, what we'll call old-fashioned marketing. But what you have to understand about real estate is a business about making connections. It's a relationship business. And I am all for having a balanced plan, but a lot of agents think that they are going to dominate in the HUD home market simply by, you know, writing a blog about it, and that's it. Now, is that a big part of it? You bet. It's a great part of it. But if you're going to market correctly, then you're going to have a balanced plan. So what exactly does a balance plan look like? Well, first of all, there's two parts to a balance plan if you're going to specialize in HUD homes. It has to include traditional marketing, but it also has to include some online marketing and social media. And, you know, some people say, well, you know, social media is better. I just want to do a little bit of online, or, you know, traditional is better. We can argue all day long. I'm going to tell you that the best plan is a combination of those, you know, both of those things. So, you know, people have to see you and get to know you to want to do business with you. If you think you're going to just send, a proposal link to an asset manager and hope that they're going to fall in love with you and give you all your business, you're pretty mistaken. It's real estate 101. It's about building those relationships. You have to build a strong brand, a brand that's trusted, in order to work in the HUD market. There's no doubt about that. You also have to come across as the expert. So traditional marketing can include things like, for example, maybe some great articles about HUD homes, maybe some great articles about the process and why a buyer needs you to help them with the process. Maybe it's an article that you put together for the asset managers that shows that you have a system, that you're out there educating other agents. We're going to talk more about that in a couple minutes. Maybe it's some quarterly reports showing some statistics and some charts and some graphs about, you know, HUD home sales in your area. Maybe it's some in-person meetings. Maybe you're doing some educational seminars for agents. Maybe you even have a HUD homes hotline. A HUD homes hotline is basically you get yourself a, 1-800 number, and people can call into that number, and you will have a recorded message that will say, here are the new HUD homes that have been listed in our area this week, and they get to listen to it, and they can, touch a number if they want you to contact them back. These are the kinds of things that you can do very easily that really, put together a fantastic, what I'm going to call traditional marketing plan. When people start hearing your voice, they can tell if you know what you're talking about. Also, maybe you need to think about creating what I call as a multi-week drip campaign. This is a campaign that will educate potential HUD buyers and keep them interested. This is a campaign that could educate potential investors and keep them interested. You could have a campaign for asset managers, and that's one of the things that, so many people want to get involved in HUD homes. They just don't know how to do these things, and that's exactly what we want to show you how to do. You got to have that traditional side. The other thing that you have to have is you really have to, and you cannot forget, about your brand online. Not all social media sites are going to allow you to have branded images. However, your online marketing, it has to start with some great information about HUD homes. Show that you're an expert. Your website should have, definitely a button for people that are interested in finding out more about HUD homes. Also, you got to post content about HUD homes on your blog, on Facebook, on Twitter, ActiveRain, LinkedIn, business, whatever, wherever you have any kind of online presence, make sure you're talking about HUD homes. The bottom line is this. If people want to do business with you, they're going to want to do business with you because they perceive that you have something that perhaps someone else doesn't have. And what I am encouraging people to think about is position yourself as an expert. You have to do that. Fran, anything that you want to expand on the outreach I've just talked about?
I think you did a great job with that, and I think it's all important. But I know there are people on the call right now who are saying, oh, but only listing agents can sell HUD homes. Only listing agents are allowed. And there are actually listing agents in some market areas right now telling their other agents in their areas that they're not allowed to market them if they're not the listing agent, and that is not true. That is absolutely not true. There may be some restrictions on signage and some stuff that the asset managers want to approve before that, but anybody who is an approved or a registered HUD broker or works for that agency is allowed to advertise HUD homes. HUD homes, and that's the beauty of it, because you don't have to be the listing broker. You can advertise the properties. You can write about them. You can do a virtual tour. You can't put them in the multi-list because, of course, only the listing agency can put them in the multi-list, but you can advertise HUD homes. You are allowed to do that. Not only are you allowed, you're encouraged. So if somebody's telling you that you're not allowed to advertise HUD homes, send them to me. send them to HUD. You've always been able to. You just have to know what the rules are. You have to follow the rules. HUD has specific advertising guidelines. If you take a look at our little slides here on the web, at the bottom right, you see we have an equal housing opportunity logo. You've got to have an equal opportunity logo or a statement attached, and there are words that you can use and words you can't use.
And, speaking of that, a lot of people don't really know that, there are the no words and there are the yes words. So, you can't say an advertised foreclosure, repo, repossession, but you can say HUD owned, HUD acquired, and government owned. So it's just a matter of when you're working, you know, within a government program. You just got to know what you can do and what you can, you know, what you can't do. So there's two parts of what I'm going to call the, you know, the HUD homes pie. One is selling HUD homes to buyers. The other is listing HUD homes. So let's talk now about how do you get HUD listings. So Fran, share a little bit of information about that.
Okay, this is the secret sauce that everybody's waiting for because people want to know now, you know, what do we do? What do we do to get the HUD homes listings? So we're going to tell you what the single most important thing that people are looking for, that asset managers are looking for. Well, they're looking for a couple things. Number one, they want to see people who are competent who are going to manage the listings well. The other part, take a look at this slide. You see this man in front of a chalkboard. They want people who are going to educate the market. They want people who are going to reach out and educate consumers, but even more important than that, they want people who are going to educate other real estate professionals, people who are going to teach them how to work with a contract, what the transaction process involves, you know, what they can do and what they can't do with advertising. They want people who are going to be, who know, you know, what the rules are as far as getting people pre-qualified and what they can do and what they can't do. This is what they want. They want people who are going to reach out, and if you come to an asset manager with a plan and say, this is, you know, this is what we can do for you. Asset managers need to get these properties sold. Right now there isn't a whole lot of activity or as much as there could be. So getting other agents and other brokers to sign up, other agents to sign up at a HUD home store, getting the market excited, you know, sharing information is key to getting the listings. Absolutely,
you know,
key. It's education.
And one of the things, Fran, you know, I bet right now there are many agents on the line, many brokers, many owners, many managers, a lot of people that are thinking, okay, this is great. I love HUD homes. I'm going for it. And they're going to rush off. They're going to, you know, go to Google, go to HUD homes, and they're going to start the process. Fantastic. Go ahead and do that. That's wonderful. But one of the things that is, you know, really going to help an agent, you know, kind of get there a lot quicker is this new certification program. I'm very excited about this program. This program is, it's incredible. And before you talk about it, Fran, because I'm going to let you tell us about it, I want to tell you what my experience has been with this. First of all, I want the listeners to know that, you know, I have been writing classes, auditing classes, for, you know, longer than I probably want to admit. And this program, you're going to love it. It's unbelievable. When I tested this program, what I loved about it was a number of things that I, for my personality and how I like to learn, and visual, so there is a visual component, there's video involved. The other thing is that it's so well laid out. There is such detail, and I'm a person that I need a lot of detail. I need a lot of stats, a lot of numbers, I need charts, I need graphs. The visual component was fantastic. Also, as you go through each of the sections, what's so nice is once you've completed the section, as long as you've gone through that section, all you have to do is you can go to the mapping section of the site and you can click on a button that says print off what I've already seen so far. What is so wonderful about that is you can print that off and now you've got this little guidebook to, you know, to take along with you and to learn. Because for a lot of people, when they go through these online courses, once they've clicked the next button, you know, not all of us, you know, can remember every single page. So this was fabulous. This is a resource center. This class is approximately 7 hours in length. It is, the beauty of it is that all the information on it stays there for 12 months. So once you complete your certification, you have access to that area for 12 months. Any updates are already, you know, they're automatically put in there and updated. So it's really incredible. Tell us a little bit, Fran, about the GHSP certification.
Okay, well, what I did was I've been working on this for a long, long time, and what I wanted to do was very, very simple. I wanted to put together a program that would give an agent or a broker every single thing they needed to be successful in with the HUD homes market as a selling agent or a listing agent. I didn't leave anything out. I mean, I just included everything they need to know about the contract, about the transaction. There's information in there about FHA financing, about 203K financing and rehab, the rehab loan, how that works, about underwriting guidelines, about compensating factors. You know, I love FHA financing. That was 80% of the business I did. FHA financing is having a renaissance right now, and there's a lot of financing information in this course. It's up to date. I've been working very, very hard keeping things up to date. You know, the down payments have increased. So it's 3.5% down with an FHA financed property. But, of course, with a lot of HUD homes with FHA financing, they're available with $100 down payment. So there's a lot of really good information. And what I really wanted to strive to do was to give people everything they needed so that when they finished, they would know everything they needed to know to be able to work with buyers. And now to be able to work with asset managers and help actually, you know, sell these houses more quickly. Decrease the market time on them, get them into hands. I mean, it's a great, great time. Interest rates are very, very low. And again, you've got people right now suffering with REO fatigue and short sale fatigue and dealing with these banks who don't tell you when they have a property inspection report. You know, I post them online for crying out loud. They post a property condition report to encourage people to go and get property inspections, turn the utilities on, get it checked. They want to make sure that these properties are fully disclosed, that people know everything there is to know about it, so they're making smart decisions, sustainable decisions, sustainable financial decisions, so they're not going to be losing their houses like so many people are right now. I just think it's great.
Well, it is. The one thing that I really love about the certification course when I went through it, what I thought was really valuable is that, once you go through the course, not only are you now certified as a government home sales professional, but now how do you take this information and how do you bring it down into a format where buyers understand it? So there's two e-books that are a part of this, which I love. One is for you, the agent. It's like your guide for sales and marketing, which really has a lot of the marketing plans that I talked about a little bit earlier. But the other e-book that I just love is the e-book for the consumer. Now imagine learning all this information and then having to explain this to your buyers. You know, it can be a little bit difficult. This is a great book where you are working with somebody. It's also a great tool. This is a downloadable document. So all you have to do is if you're building that relationship, what an incredible relationship builder to be able to email this to them and say, I want to share this with you. I'm a certified government home sales professional, and I want you to have this information. That is so powerful. The other thing that I love is that also with the certification comes 3 PowerPoints. This is very important because you have a PowerPoint that you can then use for buyers. 3 different PowerPoints all targeted to different markets. So buyers, good neighbors, real estate agents. So people can say, agents will say, well, I understand the one for buyers. That makes pretty good sense. I understand the one that is for the good neighbor program. I understand that. But what about this other PowerPoint for real estate agents? Well, the reality is, and what people don't understand with HUD Homes, is if you are trying to get that asset manager's business, you better have something to offer them. And the reality is, because there is so much unknown and so much fear around HUD Homes, if you can educate other agents in your marketplace, what you're really doing is creating a sales force. So having the PowerPoint is very, very important. So one of the reasons that I'm very excited about today's webcast and why I got involved in the first place with Fran and why I wanted to be involved in this initiative is because I'm very, very passionate about what's happened in our industry. There is so much, first of all, bad information out there. There is so much concern over the foreclosure inventory. On the flip side of it, we've just gone through a difficult market, and agents need to have this information and learn this information, but they need to be able to afford this information. So one of the things that I was really excited about when I heard that Fran put this program together, the certification program, for $97, I said to her, Fran, this is something that is going to so help agents improve their business. It's going to help asset managers sell more homes. It's going to help buyers. It's going to help teachers, firefighters, EMTs, police officers. This is a fantastic program. What I got so excited about was it wasn't just like taking a certification course and that's it, but you have everything you need if you want to to just put your toe in the water and kind of get involved with this. It gives you enough to get started, the PowerPoints and the e-books and all of that. So I was very, very excited about it. One of the goals that I know that Fran had was the goal of making this affordable. All the work that she does with, giving back and with the charity work that she's doing to make sure that people who have, you know, been foreclosed on in their homes, if there's an opportunity out there to make those things better. She's really, you know, that's a big thing for her. That was an important decision for me for even becoming involved in this because, you know, we are in, you know, we've gone through a difficult time, and it has been very difficult for agents, and this is a really great lead generation system. So if you are interested in getting your toes wet, this is a great investment. It's $97. Now, one of the things that I want to just summarize for you a little bit is that there are agents on this line that say, great, I'm going to get my toe wet. I'm going to go and, you know, invest my $97. I want to get myself certified. I want to start working HUD homes. That's wonderful. You know, but there are people out there that are saying, I want to really get into this. I want to go after the asset managers. I want to, you know, I want to dominate my market. And at the beginning of the webcast, we talked about the fact that there were two opportunities. Opportunity number one is definitely get yourself certified to be a government home sales professional. The second opportunity, this is an opportunity only for an agent that is thinking or says, look, I like this. I can do this. I want to be very serious about the HUD market. I want to make serious inroads into this market. I want to dominate my market. Or they want to be able to articulate it better. They want to have even more tools to articulate that. Because of that, there's another program, but you have to understand that the second program is, again, only for those people that are really prepared to look at HUD homes as a very important part, an addition to their business. So for the agent, perhaps, or for the broker, or for an office that sees this potential, the potential of the listing side of the program, and if you're willing to cultivate the relationships, if you're willing to take advice about things like your marketing plan, the campaigns that you're going to need to work with these asset managers, then this is an important, really important part of, you know, what we're going to talk about. Fran, explain a little bit about the role that the asset manager plays and why this part of the program, how much this is going to help them.
Okay, and I'll also share with you that I have I designed this program, this supersized program, with the advice and counsel of some asset managers around the country who are very, very excited. An asset manager is the person in the process who assigns the listings. An asset manager is responsible for opening the bids, for evaluating the bids, for managing the listing brokers, you know, and the selling brokers, and that's his job. And the asset managers are the people who are the people you want to meet and know, and these are the people that are making the decisions. They're really, really under the gun right now. They're being graded. You know, the quicker they can sell the houses, the more money that they can get, that they can, you know, the higher the list prices they can get, you know, the better they're going to look in the end. A lot of asset managers are competing for the business right now. Some market areas see multiple asset managers in the same market area. I mean, I know some market areas where there are three different asset managers. And you know what? This is all a competition because I don't think there are going to be, you know, multiple asset managers in the same regions for a long time. Because if you have one asset manager who's going to be doing an absolutely unbelievable job and has fantastic results, you know, that's what HUD needs. You know, HUD needs people who are going to be doing results. So this is going to shake down. You know, we're in an industry that's shaken down right now. You know, the realtor ranks are down, licensees are fewer. These are challenging times. And the people who are going to survive, who are going to prevail, who are going to thrive, who are going to prosper, are the people who are going to do the best job. And asset managers want to build the teams. They want to build teams with real estate agents who are going to follow through, who are going to be good listing agents, who are going to market the properties, who are going to educate other real estate agents about what to do. And this is what they're looking to build. They're looking to build teams. And that's how this whole program was designed. That's why it was designed, with their help.
And the one thing that, you know, it's, again, another myth. For anyone out there that thinks, oh, well, all the asset managers in my area, they've got their solid relationships, those days are gone because HUD homes are going to be dominated by agents that are strong agents. They are great communicators. They truly do a great job in getting the product sold. It's no longer just about, you know, who do I go and have lunch with? And the reason that's so important to know is that the asset managers are being watched very carefully, as Fran said earlier. 180 days, and then that home is being sold to a municipality for a dollar. If you're an asset manager and your track record is that you're selling homes for a dollar, I don't think you're going to be an asset manager for very long. Fran, let's talk about the next part of what we're going to call the Supersize Program, which is the, and it's actually called the Government Home Sales Professional Plus Program. Talk about the CE Ready classes. This is really a great feature of this. Explain that.
Yeah, this is based upon the classes that I'm already teaching in Arizona that already carry 6 hours of continuing ed credit. So I teach two classes in Arizona right now, and one is a morning class about the contract and the transaction. It has 3 hours of contract law. The other class is the afternoon class that's about outreach, it's about financing, and I have 3 hours of fair housing credit. So we have a new CE Ready class that's ready to be, you know, to go elsewhere, to go other places, to go to other states. And what we're offering as part of our Supersize program here, we're offering that class. We're offering the PowerPoint, the outline, so that you can submit that to the regulatory agencies that cover that.
And for those listening that are going, oh my goodness, curriculum, developing handouts, all that, that's not what this is about. This is an all-inclusive. Here it is. It's ready to go. Been designed that way because the reality is that agents, that's not where your talent lies. Your talent lies in getting out there and making relationships and selling homes, and that's where your focus needs to stay. The other thing that I really, that's really important to understand about the, you know, the PLUS program is the PLUS program also includes 100 of the books. So there's 100 copies of Fran's 114-page book, HUD Homes for Sale, A Complete Buyer's Guide. This is a really great tool because you can actually physically give the copy of the book, a physical copy, to the buyer. That's, a great feature. And, if I absolutely was a buyer, I would get very excited about having that book in my hand. The other thing that Fran has also done is included 100 of the books for real estate agents. Now, I know people are probably thinking, why in the world would I want to have one of these books for real estate agents? Well, if you own an office or manage an office, I think it's a pretty great thing to have. If you are trying to recruit people and this becomes a specialty in your office, I think this is a great tool to have. If you are perhaps an office, perhaps an agent, maybe you're doing an informational meeting to teach people about HUD homes because, again, that's what the asset managers want. What a great tool to be able to say, okay, here is your, you know, sales and marketing guide. Now, some people say, why would I do that? That's competition. What people do not understand is that, you know, this is, you know, a HUD initiative. It's a cooperative. Everybody wins if these HUD homes get sold. It's very, very important. The other thing that is a really good benefit of the GHSB Plus program is that with that, you receive 1,000 class registrations. Now, some listeners might wonder, what in the world is that? I don't understand that. Explain that to me. Fran, take a second to explain the certification and why you are actually, you know, why it's so important to have these class registrations.
If you have people who go through the class, whether they're going through the online class or that other class, they go through the class, they're going to know what it takes to sell HUD homes. So imagine you're working with an asset manager and you have 1,000 registrations in your hand that you can be working with. What can you tell them? You can tell them, I can give education online to 1,000 agents. Not only, 1,000 agents online and then do my in-person thing. That is very, very powerful. Again, people don't know what's happening in HUD homes. You can't get out necessarily in front of 1,000 people. That's real hard to get in front of 1,000 people. But if you have if you can give them a registration to a program where people are paying $97 each, when they complete the program, they take the test, they have a certificate, and they are a government home sales professional, certified government home sales professional, and you can create an army of government home sales professionals in your market area. What kind of power do you think you can have with an asset manager when it comes to getting a listing?
Absolutely. So let's talk now about the GHSB Plus package. What does that include? So, again, this is not for the listener or the agent that just wants to get their toe wet. If you want to do that, you know, just get yourself certified, $97, and you're going to, there's a wealth of information in that. But for the agent that wants to go to a whole other level and you really, really want to dominate this marketplace, I don't care if you're an agent, if you're an office, if you're a manager, an owner, this program includes everything that the $97 package has, but you get these 1,000 class registrations. You get the 200 printed books. You get the continuing education class package, which is very, very important. You know, one of the things that, the reason agents don't do this is because they don't have the tools. This package includes all the tools. So this is, again, for someone who is very serious about dominating that marketplace. I want to talk now about, okay, what kind of investment is that? What does that look like in my business? How do I get involved? What is that going to look like for me? So to get involved in the Plus program, one of the things, it's designed really for two different types of, payment options. So, for example, if you say to yourself, I love the idea of this, but, for example, I want to make sure that I get some mentoring with this. If you want to get mentoring, then the price of the program, you have got to pay that in full. If you pay that in full, then that you now become enrolled in something called Club HUD. Club HUD is very important because people that pay in full and become members of Club HUD, they actually have the mentoring side of it. The mentoring side of it is very important because that gives you access to both Fran and myself, and we're going to help you on the HUD side. We're going to help you on the marketing side, getting those campaigns created. If you also want additional training webinars, Club HUD comes with that. If you also want to participate in the monthly group HUD coaching calls that we do, again, that is only for the Club HUD members. So Club HUD members is for those who get involved at this level, but they're paying in full. You can still, one of the things that we also do with Club HUD is that for a lot of people, they don't quite know about the marketing campaigns or what do I send out to people. So we, in fact, write articles about the whole HUD program. We provide four different articles every month. Those you can mail, email, send out to your HUD Home clients. And then, of course, we also give you a choice of eight different, we'll call them frames, in order to allow you to showcase, the HUD articles. That is very, very important. If you pay in full at time of your order, for example, you become a member of Club HUD. But let's say you just can't afford to do that. That's fine, too. Everybody has a different tolerance for that. Then what you do is you can make four payments of $12.97 each, but that does not include Club HUD, which includes the mentoring and the things that we just talked about. So a lot of people that want to do this, especially a lot of, you hear a lot of offices that say, oh, help me get there. We can do that, but if you want that one-on-one, a little bit of hand-holding, a little bit more talking about your particular situation, that's where the mentoring side of it is going to be very, very important. The other thing that's really important, and I'm going to have Fran speak about this just a little bit more, is when you enroll in the GHSB Plus program, a full 20% of the program costs are donated, again, back to the charity that Fran was talking about. Fran, just let's remind the listeners again about why that's so important and what is that money doing? How does that help our current real estate industry and the foreclosure part of it?
Well, we're talking to people in the real estate industry. It's also about housing. What we're doing with government home sales professionals is we're putting housing back into real estate. We coexist, we live together, but it's not an either or. We have a sales centric job. People are selling houses, but part of our responsibility in the community, part of our responsibility to other people, is to help them keep the homes that they have. And we're doing that. We're actually putting back into this economy, back into this, housing ecosystem, 20% of what we're doing that's coming from the sales. And again, we're doing this in the name of Gabe Zimmerman. And we're giving the real estate people who are participating more than $100,000 worth of products and services for less than $5,000. From every single angle, this is a win-win for everybody. I do a lot of work with nonprofits. I do a lot of work with nonprofits in Arizona here with the Arizona Foreclosure Coalition and members of the task force. And so I kind of feel like I'm walking in two worlds sometimes, but it is one world. These are our neighbors. And everybody that we can help, every time we sell a house, we have a deal that brings the market closer to health. Every time, we have a transaction. But we can also help people keep their homes, and that's another win. That's another family that doesn't have to look for a new school for the kids. That's another family that doesn't have to live with that stigma. And so we're putting, you know, we're not only we're giving people a really, really good deal for a wonderful program, but we're driving another 20% in to help people keep their homes, and so you have a part of that. And everybody who participates in this program in any way, shape, or form is part of a healing that's going to happen in the housing sector with distressed homeowners who want to keep their homes.
Absolutely. You know, we promised that we would take no longer than 75 minutes, so I'm going to wrap up in just a moment, Fran. But, you know, if anyone's on the line and they really want to go to the next level, whether that's the dipping your toes in the water at the $97 level, or if you're fully committed, you want help, you want mentors, you want to really make this a big part of your business, then we're definitely ready to help you. Fran, why don't you tell the listeners how we get started?
Absolutely. And this class goes live. We're coming out of beta on Tuesday. So next Tuesday, all of the new classes will be live for
us. Because a lot of times people have some specific questions that they would like to have answered for them before they take any kind of action. And if you do, please just feel free to email either Fran or myself, fran@blogmilla.com or denise@thelawnsmith.com. We're happy to answer any of your questions, whatever we can do to help you be a part of this initiative. We're, you know, thrilled to do that. I want to take a moment just to thank each and every listener. You know, this has been a 75-minute call, and, you know, we promised you 75 minutes, and, you know, I hope that we provided some great information. You know, we are really thankful that we've been able to share the vision, and the vision for both Fran and I are, let's get this foreclosure inventory down. Let's help sell these HUD homes. And, you know, part of that is going to be, let's help your business. So I thank you for joining us and for joining us as partners in this vision, and looking forward to, you know, having you in Club HUD or having you certified under the certification program. And I just want to thank everybody on the line and Fran, as usual, amazing information. And thank you for, you know, just being so open and sharing everything that you know with us. So thank you, everybody.
And thank you, Denise.
Thank you.
We'll have that link up early. Very good.
Wonderful. Okay. Thanks, everyone. Take care.